are a lot of reasons that humans go to war. Money, power, glory, fame. Which are all kind of the same thing now that I think about it. But with 100+ thousand years on this planet, that list is virtually endless. But today, I want to put forward what I believe to be my candidate for the worst possible reason to go to war. To see another man's poop. In ancient Micronesia on the island of Pohnpei, war was one of the most important things, at least for the men, that anyone could do in life. In battle, a man could test himself. He could prove his courage to his clan. And perhaps most importantly, he could show that he could withstand pain, which in this society really mattered. In pre-colonial Pompeii, there was virtually nothing more socially sacred than the ability to handle pain. It set status among your clan, it provided rights above others, and once politics started to centralize, it even allowed you to rise through ranks of nobility. If you could just grit your teeth and bear it, you would be rewarded. Status-building pain was commonly first experienced through tattooing. Like some Twilight Zone bar mitzvah, a child's entry into adulthood here was quite literally punched into their skin by the teeth of a shark. It would be inflicted over a matter of days, even up to a full week, and it was done in a method that purposefully induced the maximum amount of pain. The point here was not just the memories that it was inscribing in their skin, which clan they belonged to, what their role was in society. This was torture. It was a torture meant to test their will and to determine who was the most valuable to the future of their clan. And for the men, after that tattooing was finished, they would undergo something even more painful. They would have one of their testicles sliced off just to show that they could handle that pain. But long after that ink had dried and their sac had scabbed over, those tests would still continue. Throughout their adulthood, the men of this island would forever be forced to prove their worth in combat. You could even go so far as to say it was often the war's main purpose here, at least for the commoners who were fighting it, because on this island, outside of the rare natural disaster, the resources have for the most part always been abundant. There has almost always been enough food. The population has never truly outstripped this land's fertility, and the ocean has always been available to anyone brave enough to fish it. So, it might be an overstatement to call this a paradise, but one could fairly safely argue that if people here were fighting over a resource, chances are it wasn't about survival, it was about status. Which isn't to say that's always true. Of course, there were still some resources worth fighting for, some land more valuable than others, some unique rocks, fertile fishing grounds, places of great spiritual power, but unless you were a nobleman trying to put your family on another clan's throne, it would be pretty fair to say that there was just not that much reason for war. If Pompeians were fighting, generally speaking, it's safe to assume that they wanted to be. And this is most evident in the rules that they gave themselves when conducting battle. They had strict guidelines here for what one could and could not do in war. And if you broke those, it stained you, spiritually, among your own clan. It didn't matter if you won, you still lost. It would be an act almost worse than losing. For example, generally speaking, one could only fight someone of one's own status. Even if 15 lowborn soldiers surrounded an enemy chief, they could end the war just by killing him right there. Chances are they wouldn't engage with him. They'd stand around and wait and look for someone of their status, because chiefs could only gain that status from fighting someone of their own importance. And when that battle was over, those same chiefs would be expected to eat their opponent's heart. It was equal parts respect of the social order that kept everything in line, but also disrespect of the individual who they'd just defeated. And a lowborn person simply couldn't be expected to do that. That said, now that I'm speaking about it, to call these battles a war would also be kind of a misrepresentation, because until the arrival of Europeans, most fighting here was done as raids, houses and crops destroyed, a few people killed, maybe even kidnapping a woman whose marriage they disagreed with, but really mostly status stuff. It wasn't about displacement or annihilation. Unless you were a chief looking to put your family on that throne, battle was really just a way to prove that you could take and inflict pain better than your neighbors.
But within that, There was one resource that virtually every soldier here would have been fighting over, the disgusting little nugget at the core of this tale. Simply put, a vast majority of soldiers would have been fighting that battle in the hopes of obtaining their enemy's poop. I know, but if you can get over the oddity of that, and pardon my pun, I suppose, they kind of had a solid reason for it.
Because when you consider that the average soldier would gain no wealth, no women, no status beyond what he could brag about later, poop was kind of the most tangible reason they had for fighting. It was the best possible way to display their power visibly after the war was done. If you think about it, when a person's killed, they tend to involuntarily release their bowels. But frankly, they shit themselves. And one can imagine, in a battle purely about power projection, that is the singular most embarrassing thing you can ever make your enemy do. Even the most powerful warrior, the greatest chief, the man who was most tolerant towards that tattooing, is still gonna shit himself when he dies. It's a universal shame that you, no doubt, innately understand even today. And so when that happened, for lack of a better term, they liked to rub it in. And I get that. On a deep level, too. I couldn't tell you his stats in the NBA, but I distinctly remember Paul Pierce dropping a load in his pants in the finals. Maybe that's just part of being a dude, I don't know, but it sure is memorable when it happens. You do not forget that. And so naturally, to the average Pompeian man engaging in war, worried about this shame, avoiding that moment became a very important part of that battle. And in light of that, they developed a new tradition, a way to flush their bodies out, a way to get rid of that potential shame. They called it kepwenik. It was a four-day feast where they were served a meal of raw flesh of rats, dogs, and pigs. They called it the oven of smoke, meat so raw that no stomach could possibly handle it. You can imagine what it did to them. It weakened their bodies so thoroughly that it lessened their chances of victory, but they did it just so that if they did die, they'd keep that honor inside of them.
Which led to a bit of an arms race, because with soldiers no longer emptying their bowels on death, their enemies now had to search out that shame. By which I mean, they would rip out their intestines, slice them open, and search for any undigested food they could find. Which feels like a bit much, if you ask me.
Especially when you consider that the next day, more often than not, those two warring tribes would get together, sit down, and have a feast. To apologize, effectively, but also to remind everyone who won. It was like a traditional ritual that was meant to show respect, but also power, also disrespect. Maybe a heart would be consumed, maybe some feces would be displayed, but otherwise they'd just go back to being neighbors. It was a way for the losers to show their ability to handle yet another form of pain, I suppose. To remind everyone that this was all just part of the game.
There's a lot of reasons that we go to war. Money, power, glory, fame. But sometimes, I think all we're really trying to do is just show each other who can take the most shit. This is Rare Earth. We should go get some lunch, because this is making me feel hungry.